There are more than 850 students in Greenville County schools who are considered homeless. And today the school board passed a policy to help those kids be more successful.
This is our closet.
The social worker at Hollis Academy is giving us a glimpse inside her closet, a small room full of donated items, stuffed animals, clothes, shoes.
Donated shoes, which we're running low on.
And of course, school supplies. Today, Lucilla Beaton is packing backpacks for a homeless brother and sister. Their mom had reservations about sending them to school.
She came back from out of state, and she didn't want to send the kids to school because they didn't have book bags or supplies.
Right now, there are 851 children in Greenville County schools classified as homeless. That's up from 500 last year.
Homeless definition does include those living in cars or living in tents or living under bridges, but it also can include children who are living with other people because they have no other place to live.
The challenge for many of these kids is that they're transient, switching schools two or three or more times in one school year.
Really just impacts on the child's ability to get to school on time sometimes. Sometimes there are transportation issues.
And I have seen that happen.
So today the school board adopted a new policy regarding homeless students. Most notably, it continues donation programs like the one at Hollis, continues programs at four schools that provide packaged meals for students to eat on the weekends, and allows kids to stay at their school of origin, regardless of how often they move.
The children do need that structure, that safety, that security of school.
They hope it will improve behavior and grades for a growing group of children impacted by joblessness, foreclosure, adult problems out of their control.
Since 2007, the number of homeless students statewide has grown by nearly 3,000, up to almost 9,000. Social workers tell us homeless children as young as kindergarten often struggle with anxiety.